Hey guys, Nico here. So now I'm gonna show you how to create this decorative square tile pattern easily on Procreate. Don't worry about the process. It may look like you need to spend so much time on this, but I'm gonna show you how quick and easy it is to create something like this on Procreate using our square tile brush pack. So tile designs like this are composed of a square tile base pattern, and then we're going to add layers of designs in different colors to this pattern, as well as the same effects like the shadows, highlights, random tile effects, and textures that we added to our previous artwork. Now let's open the square tile brush pack. So here we have our solid tile brush, which is the same as the one in the tile pack, but the difference is it is only focused on the square tile and the designs are here in this brush set. So I already explained the grid, highlights, shadows, random shades brushes earlier. If you want to know more about these brushes, you could check our previous video. Now, as you can see, you have different patterns and they're labeled top and bottom. The idea here is you can mix and match different tile designs that you want, and having a tile and bottom layer in different colors will make your work look more unique and more creative. So for this one, we combined pattern two, top and bottom together. The top pattern is in white, and then the bottom pattern is in dark blue. And our base tile design or a square tile design is in dark teal. So now I'm going to show you how to recreate this piece. You can follow along with your brush pack. So we're going to start with our base layer. In this case, we're going to use dark teal and the square tile brush. So we're going to zoom it out so that we're going to color this faster, because we have to fill the entire piece like this. And when we're done, we're going to add the highlights and shadows. So we're going to add two new layers, clipping mask to our base layer. And on the top one, we're going to add the highlights in white. So make sure you select the highlights brush, and then we're going to fill the entire canvas with it. Next is we're going to add shadows, so we're going to switch to the color black, the shadows brush, and on the second layer. Next, we're going to add a random shade brush, so we're going to create a new layer just below the shadows layer to add the random tile shades. Just fill the entire canvas, like what we did on our previous video. And then we could just change the opacity and the blending mode if you want to tone it down a little bit. Say 50%. Next is we're going to add our designs. So we're going to add a top and bottom pattern design. So we're going to add two layers just above the base layer. So on the top one, we're going to add a white pattern number two top. Switch to white, and then just shade the entire canvas like this. Once we're done, we're going to add the second layer, or the bottom pattern layer. So let's just select that brush, select a darker color, and on the second layer. So do the same thing, just fill the entire canvas with it. Make sure you don't miss a spot. And there. This looks perfect already, but let us add textures to add more depth to our piece. So we're going to add a new layer just below the highlights and shadows. And then we're going to choose a texture under the tile and textures brush set. So we're going to use the same one, dry and polished, and then shade the entire canvas. let's just lighten it a little bit and change the blending mode to overlay. Perfect. And then we are done. Easy, right? So let's just do a quick recap. We started with the base layer in dark teal, and then we added a white highlight and a black shadow to give that 3D tile effect. Next is we added the random shape brush, and then we added the top and bottom designs and finish it off with a really nice texture. So here's my decorative square tile artwork. I would love to see yours too. You could choose different tile patterns, mix and match different colors and designs together to create your unique piece. So tag me when you share your work because I would love to see them. So if you have any questions, just comment them below. And if you want to get this pack, the link to my website is going to be in the description. Now, in our next video, I'm going to show you how to use the hex tile pattern to create a custom lettering as well as to decorate it in different designs. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.